Hey there, thank you so much for deciding to hang out with me for a few minutes today while we cover today's video topic, which is something that I've recently implemented into my workflow, and it's something called Gotify. So Gotify is a simple server for sending and receiving messages, and I believe that, but I'm only using it to send messages to myself, either via my browser or an app on my phone. And it's something that I've known about for a while, but I've been kind of a creature of habit, and I've been getting all of my notifications via email, but I get so many emails these days that I'm tired of it. So I decided to get push notifications instead, and that's what we're going to talk about setting up in this video via a couple of different apps. So if we take a look here at their website, we can see that it's self-hosted, you control your data, it's free and open source, it's simple, it's cross-platform, and it's available in Docker, and that's why I really like it. It's because it's available in Docker. And of course, they've got, more information about their setup. They've got stuff for Android here as far as an application is concerned, but I don't know if they've got anything specifically for iPhones, the Apple devices, that sort of thing. But that doesn't affect me. I don't use anything Apple all that much anyway. I've got one device that I use as a teleprompter. But anyway, I like it because it's available in Docker, it's available on Android, and it works really, really well for what I want it to do. To give you an example of that, let's jump over here. So this is my Gotify instance in production. I've currently got it set up with Ansible and Semaphore. That video is coming. We're going to talk about my getting into that here in another video, just not this video because I'm not there yet. So I've got it set up to give me notifications when a playbook runs and lets me know the status of that playbook run. I've also got Uptime Kuma up and running for all of my different LXCs and VMs and that sort of thing. And here we can see, this was a lot of me just testing a couple of days ago to make sure that the Gotify was going to do what I wanted it to do and that Uptime Kuma was going to do what I wanted it to do. So here's the results of that. And then Watchtower here, I got a bunch of notifications this morning that there's a new image or new version of Portainer CE available. There's also a new MySQL version on 8, URLs, MySQL, Bookstack, Portainer, MariaDB, Postgres. All of those have updates available, and we can see that I got those notifications a couple of hours ago. And I got them both in my browser because I allowed notifications for this on my other PC. But I also got notifications on my phone, which was super handy to get. Because one of the things that really slowed down my consolidation and migration process for my last video was doing updates on absolutely everything, both my base OSs for my VMs and my LXCs, but also my Docker containers themselves. Even though I make these videos all of the time for everybody, I'm really bad about doing my own maintenance. So that's why I jumped into Ansible and Semaphore a little bit. It's why I decided to reinstall Watchtower. But with Watchtower, I'm just doing notifications via Gotify. I wanted to make sure that I could get all of those notifications so that I would be more top of mind, so that I would actually do them. And via Uptime Kuma and Watchtower and Ansible and Semaphore, all of that working together, I'm hoping will help me keep things better up to date and be more aware of when things are offline. Because that stuff happens sometimes. And if I don't think about it, I don't think about it, So that's why I decided to go with this setup. I love that you can come over here, on your main dashboard, it shows everything. But if you go back up to the top, you can break this down by different applications. If we come over to the menu across the top, let's just jump into this real quick. We've got users, just me. You can create new users with a username and a password and decide whether or not they've got admin privileges. They've got apps, and basically each app does a different thing. I mean, they all do the same thing, but each app will get a different token or API key or whatever you want to call it, so that you can, you can be more secure that way and have a better idea of where your notifications are coming from. And there's lots of reasons to have different apps for different things. So we can see that I've got an app for Ansible, I've got an app for Ansible Semaphore, I've got one for Uptime Kuma, and I've got one for Watchtower. You can create a new app just by clicking that, and I will just say test and tutorial, and click create. By default, it's got their logo. I think it's cute, but it doesn't help me. So you can just come over here, click the little upload thing there, find an image, maybe. Sure, why not? And then when I get a notification, it will show me that. And then you can see what your token is for that. Very, very straightforward stuff. And that's how easy it is to create an app in Gotify so that you can have an API key when you do your integration later. But I'm going to delete this because we're gonna do this from the ground up here in a moment anyway. Delete test, yes. Okay, so clients, I've got a couple of browsers and my phone. And of course, each one also gets its own token. If you need to refresh it or delete it or whatever, you can do that right from here. And I love that. You can also manually create a client. I don't need to do that, but you can. Plugins are exactly that. There's no way to upload a plugin from here. I hope eventually they let us do that. But I don't use any plugins, so I don't know what my problem is with that. Anyway, plugins are available so you can extend the functionality of Gotify if you need to do that. And then there's my account where I can change my password. I can log out, or I can switch to light mode or jump over to their GitHub repository, which I've got right here, which will also be linked in the video description if you want to check that out. I encourage you to check out all of their online resources. There's a lot of really great information in all of those. So again, links to everything in the video description. So for the sake of the tutorial portion of this video, I've just created an LXC down here, just called Gotify. That's irrelevant, but that's what I've done here. I'm gonna close that. So in there, I've got Portainer installed. I've also got Uptime Kuma installed. And we're also going to install Gotify because that's what we're here to do. So what I wanna do is actually come back over to this. I'm gonna grab this Docker Compose right here. And then I'm just gonna go to ittools.tech, Control K, Docker. And then I'm just gonna paste this in like that. No, that's wrong. That is so wrong. Nothing, cool, let's try Composerize. Sometimes this stuff happens, right? So I'm just gonna, oops, do this. Yeah, that looks better. Let's do that. Sometimes you just gotta check some things out, right? So what I'm gonna do is add a stack here in Portainer. You can do this in command line if you wanna go that route. That's just not how we're doing it here. And if you know how to do it in command line, you can extrapolate from what we're doing. So I'm just gonna paste this in here. I'm gonna do this, right? Port 80, let's do 8010, sure, why not? That's how you would change the port if you need to use something other than port 80 by default. Var Gotify data, that's fine. You can change this this part of the volume path if you need to do that. I'm gonna change my time zone though. I'm gonna do America/Denver. Cool. So that's all there is for the Gotify Docker Compose. It's very, very straightforward in its installation process. Now we're just gonna scroll down and click on deploy the stack. We're gonna give this a minute. I can't imagine it'll take too long. And then we'll jump into actually configuring Gotify and then configuring a couple of apps to use it. Cool, so there is Gotify. It is starting. We're gonna take a look at the logs. It looks like it's listening for plane connections. Cool. Look, and there may be other environment variables that you might want to use. Check their repository, their documentation, to see if there's anything that you might want to use for your setup that is specific to you. What I'm gonna do though is I'm gonna click right here on this port. And here we are. So we're gonna do admin. Cool. So the username and password is admin. You should change that. So let's actually come up to users. Let's edit this. I'm gonna do this like so. And now it's no longer admin. It's just that easy to do. So what I wanna do initially is I wanna create an app so that we can configure Uptime Kuma to give me notifications. Right, so I'm going to click Create Application. I'm gonna call it Uptime. You can name it whatever you'd like. And I'm gonna click Create. And right there, there's our icon. We can upload the icon. There's the name of our application. There's our token, the description priority, when it was last used, edit delete, right? We covered that. So what I wanna do is now come over to Uptime Kuma. And I know that there is settings. Here we go. Notifications, we're gonna come into there. And we're going to set up a notification. I'm going to come over here and I'm going to scroll up and select Gotify right there. And we're gonna call this Tut1 because I'm really creative like that. So for the server or the, sorry, the application token, we're just going to copy that and we're going to paste it right in there. The server URL, is exactly that. It's the server URL, for whatever your Gotify URL happens to be. And then default enabled and apply on existing monitors. Sure. Why not? And test. Uh-oh. Valid access token or user credentials to access this. Well, that doesn't make sense. Let's just manually copy that. Oh, that's why. That was dumb. That's why it failed. Even though I clicked copy right there, it didn't copy. So be careful with that. Now let's click test. Hey, sent successfully. If we come over to here, you might have heard that little noise. If we come to here, testing, uptime Kuma, 5-6 seconds ago. So we know it's working, right? So now we can click save. So now that we know that it's working, we can be sure that uptime Kuma will send us notifications through Gotify. If we edit this, you know, we can test it again and again and again and again. And come back over here, look, there's all of our different tests. So we're absolutely sure that that Gotify and Uptime Kuma are communicating. So when Uptime Kuma decides that it needs to send me a notification, it will absolutely do it through Gotify. We can see that right here on our dashboard. So for the sake of taking a look at something like Watchtower, for instance, let's take a look at what that will be or what that will involve. So this, well, this is Watchtower. This is the application we're going to take a look at. So basically all of this is done using a Docker run command. And of course you can take this over to something like Composerize and get a Docker compose that will work for you. However, I've already got one that I'm going to use for this tutorial. So I'm going to come over here to Portainer. I'm going to go to stacks. I'm going to add a new stack like so. And then I'm going to give it, I'm going to call this Watchtower. So if we take a look at this, we've got our services, which is Watchtower. We've kind of talked about Watchtower in the past, but when we get down here to the environment variables, what we want to do is make sure that the Watchtower notifications are set to Gotify. And then we've got a couple of other environment variables for the Gotify URL, the Gotify token. And then I also added monitor only equals true, again, because I don't want this to automatically update for me. I just want to get notifications that there are updates available. You can set that up however you want to do it, but this is how I've got mine set up. And then we've also got a host name. I'm going to call this Tut2 Watchtower, because, you know, again, originality and whatnot. So again, what we need to put in here is a Gotify URL and a Gotify token. So I'm going to come back over to Gotify. I'm going to grab that URL and I'm going to paste that right in there just like that. Then I'm going to come back to Gotify and I'm going to create another app and I'm going to create this. I'm going to call it Watchtower. And then just update notifications like so and click create. And then I'm going to view that and I'm going to get my token for Watchtower there and come back over to here and paste that in. And that's all there is to getting Watchtower set up to monitor your updates, but not update, and also send you notifications with Gotify. So I'm gonna click on deploy the stack. We'll give this a second to do its thing. Again, this should deploy fairly quickly. And then once it does, we should get a notification over here in our Gotify app. There it is. Watchtower updates on Tut2 Watchtower 3 seconds ago. And it's going to run every 24 hours and we can see when it will next run. So again, you can install this on your Android phone if you've got that. Again, I don't have any answers as far as iPhone is concerned. You may want to check out their GitHub repository for answers to that. But that's how easy it is to get notifications on your browser, on your phone, wherever you want to get push notifications for updates, whether it's, you know, whether it's uptime, whether it's updates, whatever it happens to be. There are a ton of different apps out there that have Gotify as an option. And I've just given a couple of examples of how they work here. So if you haven't heard of Gotify, now you have. And I think it's a very, very cool application. I'm actually sad that I didn't implement it into my workflow sooner. I actually really dig this app and it will probably be kind of my staple notification application for all of my stuff moving forward whenever that's available. So let me know in the comment section if you enjoyed this video, if you've heard of Gotify, if you used Gotify. I would love to know all of that. Again, in the comment section down below. Also, don't forget to like and subscribe if you enjoy this kind of... Sorry, there's a damn fly that won't leave me alone. So I apologize. Again, let me know in the comment section if you've used this before, if you enjoy it, if it's something new that you haven't heard of. Also, don't forget to like and subscribe if you enjoy this kind of self-hosting Docker, Portainer, Proxmox, all of that kind of self-hosting stuff. Like I said, I'm also going to be doing some Ansible stuff at a very high introductory level here very soon. So if you're interested in that, don't forget to get subscribed. Definitely go give the developer a star on this over on their GitHub. I'm sure they would appreciate that. If you want to support me here on the channel, you can, again, like and subscribe, but you can also become a channel member or become a patron for just $1 a month or more if you want, but $1 a month is the entry level on that. And you'll get early access when it's available, but you'll always get ad-free access to my content. No baked-in ads, no YouTube ads, none of that kind of stuff. So I think with that said, I'm going to wrap this up. Again, I want to thank you guys for spending part of your day with me today, and I'll talk to you in the next video.